Hi everyone. In this video, I'll be solving Cambridge IGCSE ICT paper 3 for the year February-March 2021. You have been supplied with the following source files. These are the files which we require for this task. Task 1, evidence document. Create a new word process document. So open a Word document for the evidence. Make sure your name and details will appear on every page of this document. So in the header, we have to include the candidate details and we have to save this as M21 evidence, followed by your center number and candidate number. So go to insert, header, you can give the name, candidate number and center number. And let us save this as M21 evidence, followed by your center number and candidate number. Task 2, image editing and file management. Create a new folder called Ocean. So this is my working area. I'll create a new folder. Right click new folder. The name is Ocean. Locate the following files and store them in your Ocean folder. So these files has to be stored in the Ocean folder. So there are 6 files here. So these are the files which we have. Apart from the evidence document and the Excel file, we need all files to be copied into this folder. So I'll copy this into this folder. You can see there are 6 files in the new folder. Next, open the file m21whaleshark.jpg in a graphics package. Edit the image by rotating it 90 degree clockwise. So we need to open this image in a image editing package. You can use Photoshop or any other image editing package. I'm using paint.net here. So right click, open with paint.net. So this is the image. First we need to rotate it 90 degree clockwise, then we need to reflect it horizontally. So click on image, rotate 90 degree clockwise. Then we need to flip it horizontally, so go to image, flip horizontally. Next part, crop it to move the text. So select, use the selection tool, rectangle select here, and you can select the image except the text because it need to be cropped out. Now click on image, crop to selection. So the image is cropped out. Crop it so all of the whale shark is visible and the cropped image is 500 pixels wide by 1200 pixels high. So we need only this part of the image and it should be with the specified dimensions, 500 pixels wide and 1200 pixels high. For that you go to image, canvas size. So the required part is in the middle of the image. So I will choose the anchor as middle, or you can choose from here the middle part. And now let us set the width. So the width is 500 and the height is 1200. Now give OK. So we got the image with the required dimension. Save this image in your OSHIM folder in .png format using the file name WS followed by your candidate number. So let us save this file, save as, inside your folder. It must be WS followed by your candidate number and the image format is PNG. Save the image. Give OK. So the image editing is done. Display the contents of your OSHIM folder showing the folder name, all file names, file extensions, image dimensions, and file sizes. In order to show all the details, right click, go to view, click on content. So that all file types, dimensions, size, everything is shown here. Now let us take a screenshot of this. Make sure the name of your folder is also included. So take the screenshot. This is your evidence one. Task 3, web page. You are going to create a web page and style sheet to promote ocean conservation. The web page and style sheet must work in any browser. All color codes except those provided in the source files must be hexadecimal. Make sure your style sheet contains no HTML. Make your HTML and style sheet are as efficient as possible. Create in your ocean folder a web page called ocean.htm. So we have to use a web authoring package here. I'm using Microsoft Expression Web. So open Microsoft Expression Web. We have to create a new web page called ocean.htm. So this is an untitled HTML page. Otherwise, you can go to File, New, HTML. Already a default page is there. So let us save this. Save as. Inside your folder, inside the ocean folder, you have to save as ocean. Save. This web page must be created using a single table and work in all browsers. The table must fit 80% of the browser window. The table must have a structure as shown in the diagram. So we can see the table has 5 rows and 4 columns. So let's insert a table. Go to table, insert 5 rows and 4 columns. And it must be 80% of the window. So 80 in percent. Give OK. Now let us do the merging. So you can see all the cells in the first row are merged. Select these cells, right click, modify, merge cells. And the height should be set to 15%. So right click, cell properties, specify height, 15%. In the next row, the first 3 cells are merged. So right click, modify, merge cells. And the width and height is specified. The width is 75 and the height is 45 in percent. In the third row, again the 3 cells are merged. Right click, modify, merge cells, and the height is 10%. Okay. In the fourth row, all the three cells have width 25 and height 20. Cell properties. Width is 25% and height is 20%. Okay. And now you can see in the second, third and fourth row, the last cells are merged together. So right click, modify, merge cells. Right click and the width must be set to 25%. Cell properties, width must be 25. And the last row, all the four cells are merged. So right click again, modify, merge cells. And the height is 10%. Okay. So now the table is ready. Each table cell is identified with a letter. Some dimensions are shown. This must be percentage. Okay, we did all that. The cell contents shown in the diagram must not appear on your final web page. Table borders must not appear. Place in cell A the image m21banner.jpg. So cell A is the first cell. Here we have to place the image m21banner. So go to insert, picture from file. Select your ocean folder. m21banner. Let's give an alternate text, banner, so that it will be shown if the image does not appear. B, a placeholder to fill the width of the cell containing video clip m21spinner.mp4. Display an automated text-based error message if the browser does not support this video type. So we need to insert a video in cell B and we need to place a holder to fill the width of the cell. That means the complete width of the cell must be taken for this video. So this is the cell B. Let us write the code for the video. Click on code. So this is the cell in which we have to insert the video. So I'll give the HTML code video. The video name is, so you have to give src source tag equals m21spinner.mp4. And it must fill the width of the complete cell. So we have to write the inline style for this. Style equal to width 100% and semicolon. Now you can close the video tag. Now let us give the error message if the video does not load. Your browser does not support the video type. So that is done. The video will be visible when you view the page in the browser. You can see the video here. The video is shown here, but it cannot be played or no controls are shown. So we have to write the code for the controls. So click on code. In this video tag itself, you have to add the property controls so that the play button, all other buttons and the controls will be shown. Let's save this and view in the browser. Now you can see the video can be played. Okay. Next one, in cell C, the image WS that you saved in step one. So cell C is the cell, this is cell C. Insert picture from file. This is the image, WS image. This is the image of a whale shark. Image is inserted. Place inline style attributes into the HTML so that each image fits the width of the table cell. That means the images which we inserted in cell A and in cell C must take the complete width of the table cell. So we need to, and it must be set as inline style attributes. So we need to change that in the code. This is the first image, select the image, go to the code. Remove the height and width which is given here. We have to give the inline style, so write style, style equals width equal to, it must width colon, okay. It must be 100% because it must occupy the complete cell width. 100%, give the semicolon. Same way for this image, select the image, go to the code, remove the height and width and add the inline style. Width 100%. Place in cell D the contents of the file m21ocean.txt. Cell D is this one below the video. First, open the file m21ocean.txt. This is the file. You can copy the text. Make sure all text are copied and it must be placed in cell D. Cell D is the cell. Paste it here. Display this text as two paragraphs. Add as the third paragraph the text web page updated by. Web page updated by. Candidate name and details. Apply the style P to all text in cell D. So select all text. Click on the styles here and we have to apply style P or the paragraph style. So I will select paragraph. Place in cell E the text species. This is cell E. So place the text species here, then ocean waste, and next contact us to help. All this must be set as style H1. Select the three cells, set as style H1, heading 1. Place in cell H the contents of the file M21 text.txt. So open that file. Copy the text, Control A, and then copy it. Paste it in this cell. And it must be set as style H2. Set it as style H2. Attach the style sheet m21ocean.css to this web page. Save your web page. So in order to attach, click here, attach style sheet. Browse. This is the style sheet m21ocean. Click on open and give OK so that it is attached to the web page. Now save the web page. Open and edit the style sheet m21ocean.css to meet the following specifications. Open the style sheet m21ocean. Center align all the tables within the browser window. So the table is given here, we have to center align. So we need to modify the style. You can see all the styles here. So table style, right click, modify style. So we need to set the margins from left and right as auto so that the table will be center aligned. For that, click on box. You can see the margins. Deselect this. The right margin should be auto and left also auto. So the margins from both right and left will be set as auto so that the table will be center aligned. Give OK. Next, set the background for the web page so that it has a color with blue component, red and green, the values are given here. So we need to set the background color. For that we need to add the style body. So go to format, new style. We can add the style body, background. Background color must be RGB, the color follows RGB, so red is 9A, then AB and D5. So 9A, second component AB and then D5. So this is the RGB format, I have entered the values here, give OK. Next, set the font for styles H1, H2 and paragraph style. That means H1, H2 and P so that the browser selects and displays the font Arial. If it's not available, Verdana, and if it's not available, Sans Serif font. Give OK. So we need styles for H1, H2 and P. So format, new style, you can write the style separated by comma, H1, H2 and P. The font family is Arial, comma, Verdana, comma, Sans Serif. Next one. Set style H1 to be center aligned. H1 is already defined, so we just need to modify it. So So right click, modify style. It must be center aligned. So click on block, text align must be center. Next, set style H2 and paragraph style as fully justified. H2 as well as paragraph or P. So go to format, new style, H2 comma P must be set as fully justified. Go to block, text align, justify. Give OK. So that's done. Add your name, center number and candidate number as a command at the start of the style sheet. At the start of the style sheet, add the command. Command is given by slash star, give a space, then give your name, candidate number and center number. Then star slash. So this is how you give the comment. Save the style sheet in your OSHIM folder. Take a screenshot to show the file name and all the contents of your style sheet. So save this. Now we need to take the screenshot of this style sheet. Along with the name. And that is your evidence too. Since the borders are given as 0 pixels, the borders won't be visible on the final web page. Next, display the HTML source of your web page in your editor. Take a copy of the HTML source as evidence 3. So, this is your web page. Click on code, which shows the HTML code. You can copy this. Select all text, copy. And that must be given as evidence. So the HTML source is pasted here. Next one, display the web page in your browser. If necessary, resize it so that all page can be seen, all text can be easily read, and the address bar is visible. Place in your evidence document screenshots showing the web page in your browser. So let us show the web page or preview the web page in the browser. File, preview in browser. So this is your browser. You can resize it so that it is completely visible. So you can take the screenshot. The web page is completely visible now. All the text are also visible. Let's take the screenshot. When you are taking the screenshot, please make sure the address bar and all the text are visible. That is your evidence. This is the final web page. So this is the end of the web page task. Task 4 is printing the evidence document. So your evidence document is ready with 4 evidences. This document has to be printed. Next task is the data analysis task. It is uploaded in another video. You can find the link in the description. Please keep watching my channel and check out for the new videos. Thank you for now.